Jason.
Did you pay Royo to help you steal Christina?
No, I didn't do it, I swear. Look at me. There's love between us. It may not be working so well at the moment, but it's there and it's real and it's something I honor. So when I look at you and swear before God that I am telling the truth, I had nothing to do with Christina's disappearance. Do you believe me, Jason? Do you love me enough to trust me?
Sam, I love you. But I gotta know. I have to be 100% sure. I trust what I see. And I want to believe that you didn't take Christina, but the facts say you did.
The facts, Jason? Not all of them. There are just as many facts that say I didn't do it. Facts that you already know. Look past the so-called evidence and see me. Sam. The person you lived with. Who you've slept with. Who agreed to marry you. I mean, Jason, really, start by asking yourself, why? Why? Why would I rip an innocent little girl away from her mother the way Hope was taken away from us? I mean, at least Hope was an infant. She wasn't old enough to make any binding attachments, but Christina has. Can you imagine how frightened she must be without her mother? I mean, do you honestly believe I could hurt a child that way, really? Look, I'm not gonna lie and say that I don't envy Alexis with every fiber in my being. Her child lived, mine didn't. And if I had the power to go back to the night my baby was born and save only one little girl, you better believe it would be my own. But I would never, never take Christina because I wanted a baby of my own. That is more selfish and cruel than I know how to be. Just please say you know me well enough to believe that, Jason, please. Jason, please don't close, please.
No. They found it in a box of Sam's things. I know you don't want to believe that Sam did this, but the evidence is piling way too high. I'm telling you, I think Sam took Christina.
Did you just listen to what you said? The evidence is piling too high? Doesn't it strike you as a little too convenient the way all the cards are stacked against
Sam? No, what strikes me is you're way too much in love to see what's right in front of your face. When are you going to stop thinking with your heart and help me get my kid back?
You're desperate to pin this kidnapping on Sam, and I understand why.
Why?
Why? Because you know that if Sam had your daughter, she would keep her safe. You don't want to believe that Christina was grabbed by an enemy who would use her to hurt you. But I'm telling you, every second we waste looking at Sam, you're just letting the real kidnapper get further and further away.
What's wrong with this picture? Usually I'm the one who gets blindsided by emotion. You see things the way they are. It's how we work. It's too late in the game now to change the rules. I just want you to look at the facts. All right? Sam wants a little girl to make up for the two she lost. She's single-minded when it comes to getting what she wants, and she knows how to run a con. And she's one of the most convincing liars around. What is so hard for you to get?
She broke into the house. She took the money. She even spoke to Christina, but she did not kidnap her.
I'm starting to lose my patience now. I get that you love this woman. Christina's my daughter, my flesh and blood.
You know, I'm just gonna leave before one of us says something we regret.
I'm just trying to say to you, you need to get focused.
I did not send a ransom note because there was no reason to. I did not kidnap Christina.
You know this case is personal to me.
What, is that a threat?
No, I'm just trying to say that if you cooperate with us, I will do whatever I can to go easy on you. And we can make a deal. Just tell me where Christina is.
Rick, for the millionth time, I don't know.
Get anything? What's happening?
Steve adamantly denies any involvement.
Which shouldn't come as a surprise to anyone. You know, I want to take Miss McCloud back to Sonny's place, walk her through every step she claims to have taken, and then compare the reenactment to her sworn statement.
That's a good idea. I'll make arrangements.
All right, come along. Thanks. What are you thinking?
Could it work?
God help me, but I can still read your mind. I know what you're thinking, and you're not going to sit idly by and watch the authorities handle this because you don't think they're capable of it. You have your own ways of breaking people, illegal, unconscionable, immoral ways.
Where are you going with this? Because I don't want to, I'm not in the mood for any of your, you know, sanctioning.
Saying, do it. Do it. You do whatever it takes to get her.
Hey, something's happening down by the lake if you want to check it out, okay?
You've been lying this whole time, but you're going to tell us the truth now. Where did you take Christina?
I look into the mirror. See myself. I'm all over me. I need space for my desires. I have to die to my fantasies. I know as soon as I arrive, everything is possible. Because no one has to
come. One more time, Alexis. I don't know where she is.
Stop right there. Why are you doing this?
Sorry.
Step out of the way, Jason.
You're not gonna shoot anybody.
I don't want to, but you've gone off the rail.
I know exactly where I'm
going.
You're
protecting the woman who kidnapped my daughter.
Sonny, I didn't take Christina. I would never do anything to hurt your little girl.
She didn't corrupt the security system. She didn't shadow wire the house. She had no reason to.
What about the note? They found the same thing.
But the note, they must have planted the note. They know the frame Sam because they saw her break in on the surveillance cameras. All they gotta do is keep leaving clues to prove Sam did it. Everybody's gonna believe them.
Hands behind your head.
There's a key under that pocket.
I got it. Jason, I won't kill me. stay here? Does Sonny know about this place?
Sonny's not gonna tell anyone we're here.
I'm sorry, I'm hurting you.
It's okay, you gotta press harder to stop the bleeding.
Jason, I gotta warn you, I'm a terrible nurse, okay? And I really, no, I hate no, the sight of blood.
You're doing fine.
You know, I can't believe you got me away from the police when you did. You were the only one who believed me. Why? Why did you believe me? No one else would.
It was just easier for me because I know you. I could tell that you were being honest.
You know, no one has ever believed in me. No one has ever given me the benefit of the doubt. Much less fought for me, but you did. You did.
It's because I love you.
I had no idea what love was. How it felt, what it meant, until you showed me. Jason, I love you. Okay? I love you so much. Jason, this isn't working. You are bleeding like crazy.
No, you just gotta keep pressure on it.
You're getting worse. You need to be in a hospital.
No, Sam. No.
Yes, Jason, I have to call an ambulance.
No, the cops will come.
I don't care. Put me in jail. Jason, I can't see you bleed to death.
I've made it through worse. We just gotta get through tonight.
You're so pale. You're so pale.
Don't panic.
Okay.
Okay. When I'm stronger, we'll go look for Christina together, okay?
Together. Jason. Jason! Jason, don't do this to me! Jason! You're showing
what?
Me the chart.
What's going
Jason
on?
Jason has been shot and he needs your help.
Excuse me. Sorry. Has there been any gunshot victims admitted within the last hour?
I have no idea. I just came on shift.
Listen, this is urgent. We are looking for two fugitives, Jason Morgan and Sam McCall. We're searching for two fugitives, Jason Morgan and Sam McCall.
I don't see anyone in medical gunshot, so you need to come with me and help me, please.
All right. Dr. Quartermain. Excuse me, I need to talk to you about your son.
Jason. What's
going on? Little boy. I went straight through. I think I need some stitches.
Okay, I'll take care of it. Let's get him on the bed. Come on. It's all right. Oh, sweetheart. You see? Just a little bit more. Come on. There you go. Easy.
Thank you for doing this.
I am your mother, Jason. Of course I'm going to take care of you. No one followed us. I was careful.
Sammy took a big risk.
Yeah, well, I wasn't going to let you die. From what I could tell, the internal damage is minimal.
But he runs a very, very high risk of infection, and he should be in a hospital.
I told
him. Yeah, I know. Well, he's strong and he's in good health, so with medication and rest, he should recover.
Well, he's passed out. I'm kind of glad he's passed out. He was in so much pain, I really thought he was going to start to cry. Isn't it weird, though, how when someone you love is injured, you want to take the pain away for them?
You did just fine. You were very helpful.
But you saved his life. And I will owe you forever for that. Not that my gratitude matters, because he's your son and you love him and you would have saved his life anyway. So
yes.
I don't know.
Yes. He's my son and I love him. And obviously you do too.
You know, I have never felt like this about anyone before. Jason believed in me when no one else would. He risked his life for me. You know, I would do anything for him.
Turn yourself in?
Turning myself in is the only way to save Jason. I'll call the cops right now.
Don't. Let's give him time to pull through on his own.
You were testing me, weren't you?
I'm trusting my son's life with you. I need to know if he would put his welfare ahead of yours.
He's really lucky to have you as a mother.
Jason can be a very difficult person. Cold and unfeeling on the outside. But truly devoted to those that he loves.
Yeah.